Okay, so today we learned the concept of density, and the main significance it has is it determines whether an object will float or sink in a liquid. So let us see that also, how it determines. Okay, so first we will start with the demonstration of finding out what sinks and what floats in water. Okay, so I have a beaker of water. This is a clay ball. Do you think it will float or sink in water?
Sink.
Sink. It sunk. And what did you observe when it sunk in the water? What did you observe when it sank in the water? The water level went up and it appears to be bigger in size. So it appears to be bigger in size due to what property of light? Refraction of light. Very good. And the water level raises up because of?
Because of volume, so the clay has volume.
The clay has a fixed volume and it occupies a certain space. So it displaces the water equal to that volume. Agreed? Okay. Now one more observation you will do. Okay, let me get a spring balance from whatever. No, that's okay. So now, see, right now when it is in the air, it has some weight. I can feel some weight, right? When I am holding it in my hand, I can feel some weight. So when it is fully immersed in water, do you think it will feel lighter or heavier?
Lighter.
Why?
Because of upthrust.
One at a time.
Upthrust.
What causes upthrust?
Sir, when you put an object in the water, the pressure that it puts on the water is equal to the amount of pressure that the water is putting on the object. So that is what.
Wait a second. Why is it equal? Okay, let us see. Yeah. Okay, right now it is showing zero because there is no weight. Now in air, let us see what is the weight. Can you read it?
0.50.
Okay, in terms of okay, 0. Let me see. Yeah, 0.50 newton. So let me write it down. So weight in air is 0.50 newtons. Okay. Now you all predicted that inside water its weight should be lower. Now what is the weight?
Exactly half, 0.25.
Can you hold it? I want to check it without parallax. Yeah, it's 0. So weight in water. 0.25 newtons. So what is the loss in weight?
Calm down, move your head please.
Loss in weight is 0.25 newtons. Okay. Now I will tell you one statement which says that this loss in weight, okay, see it's like this. Suppose somebody ties him to a rope and hangs him from the ceiling. Not from the neck, from the shoulder. Okay, not from the ceiling, let us say, what's your name?
Archimedes.
Let us say Archimedes is holding the rope. So he is like this.
Archimedes will draw the rope.
So the rope is tied here and somebody is holding the rope like this.
Whoever is holding
okay.
The rope.
So the entire weight of this boy, which is weight in air, is going to act on the rope. Agreed? So it, let us say he is 60 kg, so 600 newtons. Let us say 60 kg, 600 newtons. So this is the weight in the air and he is getting very tired, he is not able to hold. So in order to support this, he has to apply a force of 600 newtons right now. Agreed? So it's very heavy. So he says, I can't hold on any longer, somebody help. So somebody comes from below and catches him from below and applies some force. So this upward force is, let us say, 200 newtons. So from below, somebody pushes this man with 200 newton force. How much force do we have to exert now?
400.
So this is what is happening. Something like this is happening in the case of an object which is immersed in a liquid. So in air, you have to apply the entire weight of the object, which is weight in air. But once it is immersed in liquid, the surrounding liquid. So if this is immersed in a liquid, this man is doing the job of the surrounding liquid. It's pushing from all sides.
So
when an object is immersed inside a liquid, the surrounding liquid is pushing it from all sides. The resultant of all those pushes is an upward push.
So what,
it pushes from up also? But you will find later on that the push from up is less than the push from down. I will explain why. You will understand it slowly. Why the push from down is more than the push from up? But if you take a liquid, it's the actual forces are like this. If the length of the arrow tells you the strength of the force, as you go down, the length of the arrow gets bigger and bigger. Who can tell me why?
More pressure below.
Excellent. Pressure increases with depth. Here the pressure is less. Here the pressure is more. Here the pressure is even more. Here the pressure is maximum. And force exerted by the water is pressure into area. So if the pressure is more, the same area will exert more force. So actually, at the bottom of the object, pressure is maximum. So force exerted by maximum pressure is maximum. So when the object is completely immersed in the liquid, overall force on it is maximum from below, less from above. So the net force is upwards. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Which we call as buoyant force. So like this boy who is holding it up with 200 newton force, that will be the buoyant force. So BUOYANT, buoyant force, or upthrust. Both are the same thing. So if he applies a 200 newton buoyant force, wait, sit. Go back. If he applies a 200 newton upthrust, the loss in weight is equal to how much? His weight in air is 600. Buoyant force is 200, and the new measured weight in water is 400. So what is the loss in weight? What do you see the pattern? What pattern do you see? From 600 the weight became 400 in water. So what is the loss in weight?
200.
And what is the force exerted by the liquid?
200.
So can you see a, can you come out with a rule? The loss in weight of an object when immersed in liquid is equal to the buoyant force. Buoyant force or upthrust. What? See, this is the weight in air, this is the weight in water, which is less than weight in air. It decreased by how much? By this much. It decreased by this much because the water is pushing up with this much. Yes. So, upthrust exerted by water on the immersed object. Yes. Yes. So, this gives rise to Archimedes' principle. Archimedes' principle, please note it down. Any object immersed partially or completely in a liquid experiences an upward force. Please note this down. Right? You have to write it down. Right. Take a notebook and write it down. Called buoyant force. I will check your notebook. or a thrust. Yes, I will check. If you have not written all this, you won't be able to go.
So all this is the
a whole thing called point force and others, which is equal to the loss in weight of the object when immersed the liquid. I'll add one more thing. And also equal to the weight of the displaced liquid. Now I will prove this to you. This is an extra statement I have made for Archimedes principle. I am saying that whatever is the loss in weight of the object when immersed in liquid, it is equal to the weight of the displaced liquid. That means Listen carefully. Suppose this is the water level. I immerse an object which has volume V. Okay? Whatever volume of water was present here, if this object is occupying that space, can flow water be present in that space? Earlier there was water here. Now I am putting this clay ball here. Whatever space clay ball occupies, can the water which was present earlier in that space be still present there? So where did it go? It will rise up. So let us say it rises up to this much. So this volume should be equal to this volume. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
So the water which was present here, it has gone up. So you have lifted some water up by immersing an object inside the water. So will this water have a weight or not? Will it have a weight? So if the water has been lifted up and it has weight, it will try to come back down? Yes or no? How can it come back down to its original space? If this water comes back to its original space, what will happen to the clay ball? It has to come out of the liquid. How can it come out of the liquid? By rising up. So now we understand how that upward thrust is produced. It's produced by the weight of the liquid which was displaced. Since this object came in and displaced this liquid out, the weight of this liquid is trying to come, apply back on the clay ball and push it back out. So upthrust is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. Now let me prove it to you by demonstrating it.
What about this?
I'll take a question after this.
Because the bell rings. Could you wait for 2 minutes? Copy down.
Wait. You can copy it. Let me finish the demonstration. Then I will give you time to copy it down. So now I want to. So this is a Eureka can. So it has a hole here from where the excess water will spill out. So the plan is I will fill it till the brim. Okay. And then I will measure the water which spills out, which is displaced, and I immerse the object. That is the plan. Understood? Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So let me fill it with water first.
Kanda,
I don't know why it is called Eureka, man.
Archimedes used to be said
Eureka.
Maybe.
Right. Now initially I have filled it above the hole. So let it spill out. Once it stops spilling out, are we focusing on the spilling? Did you focus on this Eureka can?
Yes, sir. The focus
okay,
is
so
on.
Okay, so now it has stopped. Okay, wait, it's still spilling. Okay.
I need to go on this fan.
Okay, now. Okay, now stop finally. Okay. Okay, now let me wipe this down. Okay, now I will immerse this. Wait. First I need to measure the weight of the beaker and make sure that is cancelled out. So right now the electronic balance shows zero. Okay, you can focus on this electronic balance also. So right now it shows zero. I place the empty beaker. It shows some value. So I press tab. So now with the empty beaker it is showing zero. So next if I fill the water in the displaced water in the beaker, it will give me the direct weight of the displaced water only, not the beaker. So now I will take it, keep it here. Now I will displace it. Okay. So now the weight of the displaced water will be obtained by measuring the weight of this water. Agreed everybody? Water got displaced due to the volume of the stone is this water only. So I will measure the weight directly. How much is it showing? 16.6 grams. So weight of displaced is 16.6 grams, which is 0.0166 kg into 10 meter per second square. So, are you understanding what I am doing?
Yes, sir.
Please go back. No, you are blocking the board from the view.
Sir, the weight is equal to 16.6 newton.
Listen, weight is m into g. Okay. Right now, this is mass in grams. So, to get the force in newton, so that I can compare with this, I have to convert the gram mass into weight in newtons. So first I convert it to kg. So divide by 1000. So 0.0166 kg. And then I multiply with small g, which is gravitational field, which is 10 meter per second square. Or 9.8 meter per second square. So m into g is weight. So it gives me 0.166 newtons. So this
we can take it as 0.17.
So yeah, we can take it as
0.17
newtons. Now compare it with this. It is supposed to be 0.25 newtons, yes, but it is less. So that is due to the error in our measurements. It's not a very accurate way we have done. Some water which is so the water displaced is having less weight than what we predicted. But this one itself, the spring balance itself has an uncertainty measurement. So what is the least count of the spring balance?
Also, we don't know where
the least count of the spring balance is 0.5, 0.10, 0.15. So the least count of the spring balance is 0.5. So this is actually plus or minus 0.5. The smallest division in the spring balance is 0.5. Wait, 0.05.
So basically it's less due to human error.
So if you go with the lesser value, it will be 0.20. So it could also be 0.20 newtons.
So basically
it is close to 0.17.
So basically this is due to lack of human error.
If you round this to one decimal, it becomes 0.2, which matches with this.
So basically we can say this is human error.
Yeah, the measurement has some uncertainty, so the spring balance measurement can be rounded off to 0.20 newton, and if you round this also off to one decimal, it agrees with the measured balance.
So let's just leave it to a human.
So we can say that both of them are actually agree, and Archimedes' principle is verified. Are you following what I did? So weight of the displaced liquid is only contributing to the upthrust, okay, and appearing as buoyant force and causing a loss in the weight of the immersed object. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I am not getting convinced.
Yes, sir.
Okay, wait. Now, density, do you understand what is the meaning of density?
Yes, sir.
Tell me what is density.
Sir, density is basically the mass of an object.
Density is not mass of an object.
Sir.
Yes.
So, it's the amount of particles in a particular area.
No.
It shows that.
No.
Sir, it's how close the molecules
are. So, the mass in a particular area.
Density tells you the concentration of mass per unit volume. Mass per unit volume is density. Please write it down. Density is mass by volume. This is mass. You can express it in kg. Volume can be in meter cube. So density will be kg per meter cube. So now, let us measure the density of different objects. So one easy way is, yeah, you can measure the volume of each of these objects using this displacement of water using Eureka can. So let us first measure the density of this aluminium block, okay? So let me fill this with water like before. And then we will measure the volume of the displaced water. Yeah, this plate is actually uneven.
Sir, I have an idea, so what you could do it?
Okay, wait, it's okay. The water is... Okay. Good idea.
But then how will we see?
So you can see it once the water stops dripping, no?
With the bars.
It's broken. This Eureka can is broken. Okay, just get a new one. Get a new one. It's broken. Replace it. Pause the recording. Yeah, fill it. So to measure the density of different objects, you need to measure the mass, measure the volume. Agreed? So mass by volume will give you density. So what we can do is keep it on the electronic balance and you will get the mass. Okay? And then to find the volume, you can fill this with Eureka can. You can fill the Eureka can. That's the trick. The density of water. Density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, listen. So suppose if the mass which you measure in electronic balance comes out to be like 100 grams. So what is the volume? Density is mass by volume. So volume is mass by density. But density is 1. So it will be just 100 grams by 1.
Okay, Google. Hey, Google. Okay, Google.
So mass of water is equal to the volume of the water. If you have 100 grams of water, it will have 100 centimeter cube as volume. Are you getting it?
Okay, Google.
So we can measure volume indirectly by measuring the weight, which is equal to the mass if you have it in grams. The electronic balance measures the weight, but it gives you the value of the mass in grams. So once you get the mass in grams, you get the volume in centimeter cube. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
So
yes.
Answer is not following. We lost interest. Okay, Arthur. That's what he said, right? What did I say? I said Adhya only, right?
Adhya, I guess so.
Okay. So let's do it. Okay, we'll find the mass density of this clay ball first. Okay? So first let's find the mass. So tear it to zero.
Why are you pouring this? So you can take this. Very great. So let me measure the. How much is it? 54.4. So density of ball 54.4.
God,
54.2 grams divided by the volume in centimeter cube.
So we'll have to try it
out. So let's tear the beaker. Press
Tane.
Tear.
Tane, move.
Now I'll keep it here.
Tane. Tane.
Tane, are you blue?
Tane, why are you blocking the camera here?
Yeah?
So now let's keep it here. Okay.
So the bell is
wrong. Wait a minute, please. Did I say leave? Okay, 17.0. So grams will become centimeter cube. So volume is whatever you calculate here. 54.2 by 17.0 is how much? 54 divided by 3.1. So 3.1 grams per centimeter cube is greater than 1 gram per centimeter cube. So it sinks in water. As far as the density of the object is more than the density of the liquid, it will sink.